परम सुखद केवलं ज्ञानमूर्तिं द्वन्द्वातीतं गगन सदृशं तत्त्वमस्यादिलक्ष्यं एकं नित्यं विमलमचलं सर्वधी साक्षिभूतं भावातीतं त्रिगुणरहितं सद्गुरुं तं नमामि नित्यानन्देश्वर परमशिवसमारम्भां नित्यानन्देश्वरि पराशक्तिमध्यमां अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्परां ललाटे त्रिपुण्ड्रीनिटिलकृतकस्तूरीतिलकः स्फुरन्मालाधारस्फुरितकटिकौपीनवसनः दधानो दुस्तारं शिरसि फणिराजं शशिकलां प्रदीपः सर्वेषाम् अरुणगिरियोगी विजयते ॐ गणानान्त्वा गणपतिगं हवामहे कविं कवीनामुपमश्रवस्तमं ज्येष्ठराजं ब्रह्मणां ब्रह्मणस्पत आनश्रण्वन् भूतिभिः सीदसादनम् ॐ श्रीमहागणपतये नमः प्रणो देवी सरस्वती वाजेभिर्वाजिनीवती धीनामवित्यवतो सरस्वती नमः श्रीगुरुभ्यो नमः हरिः ॐ श्रीकान्तो मातुलो यस्य जननी सर्वमङ्गला जनकशङ्करो देवस्तं वन्दे कुञ्जराननं यः शिवो नाम रूपाभ्यां या देवी सर्वमङ्गला तयोः संस्मरणात् पुंसां सर्वतो जयमङ्गलं सर्वतो जयमङ्गलं सर्वतो जयमङ्गलं या देवी स्तूयते नित्यं विबुधैर्वेदपारगैः सा मे वसतु जिह्वाग्रे ब्रह्मरूपा सरस्वती दोर्भिर्युक्ता चतुर्भिस्फटिकमणिमयीम् अक्षमालां दधाना हस्तेनैकेन पद्मं सितमपि च शुकं पुस्तकं चापरेण भासा कुन्देन्दुशङ्खस्फटिकमणिनिभासमाना समाना सा मे वाग्देवतेयं निवसतु वदने सर्वदा सुप्रसन्ना चतुर्मुखमुखाम्बोजवनहंसवधू मम मानसे रमतां नित्यं सर्वशुक्ला सरस्वती शारदा शारदाम्बोजवदना वदनाम्बुजे सर्वदा सर्वदा अस्माकं सन्निधिं सन्निधिं क्रियात् नित्यानंदम् We welcome all the prince and princess of His Divine Holiness Swamiji, all the balasins of the Nityananda Gurukul, all the devotees and viewers of Nityananda TV, Facebook Live and YouTube Live who are watching this program of explanation and translation of the Agamic scripture called Samrajya Lakshmi Pitika, which is from the Ananda Bhairava Tantra. Today is the second day of this series of Samrajya Lakshmi Pitika. Yesterday, we started the scripture, we started this Agama, which is directly revealed by Paramashiva himself, the Devi Parvati. We yesterday saw the ambience of the place where this Agama was revealed. It was revealed in Kailasa, and how Paramashiva is seated, how the form of Paramashiva is, we saw yesterday. Today we will continue the rest of the verses. We started and finished six shlokas of the Samrajya Lakshmi Pitika. We will continue to read the six verses first and then continue to the next seventh verse. Please repeat the shlokas after I repeat. Please repeat twice. कैलास शिखरे रम्ये रत्नमंडपमध्यमे दिव्यकल्पतरोर्मूले रत्नसिंहासने शुभे आसीन मंतिकासीन चतुर्मुख मुखामरम कोटि सूर्य प्रतीकाशम दुर्निरीक्षं सुरासुरैः अनर्घरत्नमकुट कुण्डलाङ्गदभूषितम् सुधाकर कराकार हारवार मनोहरम् चतुर्भुजं पंचवक्त्रम् प्रतिवक् त्रम त्रिलोचनम् गंगाधरम् चंद्रमौलिम् व्याघ्रचर्मोत्तरीयकम् मृगं वरञ्च परशुम् अभयं दधतं करैः सेव्यमानं मूर्तिमद्भिः अष्टैश्वर्यैरहर्निशम् नंदीश भृंगि प्रमुखैः प्रमथैः परिसेवितम् मुनीन्द्रैर्योगिवृन्दैश्च दिक्पालैश्च समावृतम् Yesterday we saw till this. Today we'll continue with सर्वलक्षण संपन्नम् सच्चिदानंद रूपिणम् सर्वलोकैकजनकम् नत्वा देवं महेश्वरम् समस्तलोकजननी पार्वती प्राहधूर्जटिम् भगवन् देव देवेश वात्सल्य करुणानिधे श्री श्रुतं त्रैलोक्य वृत्तांतम्। त्वन्मुखं भोजतः पुरा इदानीं श्रोतुमिच्छामि। माहात्म्यम् अतिपावनम् साम्राज्यलक्ष्म्या सर्वज्ञ। तन्मे विस्तरतो वदा So yesterday we saw Paramashiva is seated in a gemstones studded simhasana under the divine kalpavriksha, and he is surrounded by Nandi, Bhringi, Devi, Para, Skanda, Vrishabha, all the Ganeshwaras and all the Dashadik Palakas. And now the state of Paramashiva is explained in the next shloka. State and the form. Sarva lakshana sampannam. With all the lakshanas, all the lakshana means how something should be. Lakshana means how something should be. The description on the rules and regulations of how something should be. If you say a man, he has to have mustache, he has to have beard, like that in the loka, in the world, we have description of each and everything, how something should be. If you are a disciple of Swamiji, then you will be wearing a kantamala. Like that, there are various descriptions. Like that, all the great descriptions of the divine are there in Paramashiva. Sarva lakshana sampannam, sachidananda rupinam. So we said Paramashiva is seated, Shiva is seated in all these form, way he holds the deer, he holds the axe, he is having abhaya hasta, varada hasta, etc. and all. But who he is what matters the most. He is the embodiment of the sachidananda. The Vedas explain, the Vedas describe Brahman, the ultimate, as the embodiment of Sat, Chit and Ananda. Sat means truth. Sat means the state of being. Everything that is there in this world, everything that we can imagine even, which is not there in the world, but we can, even with that which we can have in our imagination, also has a some quality that is called satta. Satta means the quality of being. Unless something can be, nothing can exist even in our imagination. So the quality of being, the state of being is called sat. Sat is the state of being. Chit is consciousness. Chit means consciousness. Everything that we see, whether this is this mic or this Rudraksha, the seat on which I am sitting, the lights and the camera, the floor, everything has a state of being, but they do not have consciousness. They are not able to become aware of something. So the quality of the consciousness is not radiated by them. All the animals, all the creatures, all the living beings are able to experience that consciousness, chit. That is why we call them living. Anything that is living has chit, has consciousness. Ananda is bliss, which can be experienced by all of us, all the human beings, and all the beings who are above the level of human beings. All these three qualities are directly the qualities of the ultimate consciousness, Paramashiva. The Parabrahma, the ultimate being. Paramashiva is described as the embodiment of Sat, Chit and Ananda. Sat, Chit, Ananda, Rupinam. Next, it says, Sarvaloka Ika Janakam. Sarvaloka Yeka Janakam. The sole creator of all the worlds. How can somebody, something be a sole creator, only creator for all the worlds? Because we see if this mic, the mic is created by somebody who created the mic in the industry, in the factory. Somebody created. If there is a pot, then the pot is created by a potter. Then how do we say that Paramashiva is Sarvaloka Yeka Janakam? Paramashiva is the sole creator, the one and only creator of the all the worlds. The Vedas explain, the Upanishads explain that Paramashiva is not just the instrumental cause of the creation of the whole universe, but also the material cause of the whole universe. For something to be created, we do have two things that are required, the instrumental cause and another one is the material cause. The instrumental cause is the person who creates. For example, if a pot is to be created, then the potter is the instrumental cause. He becomes an instrumental creation of a pot. So he is the instrumental cause. But he uses some other material called clay out of which he creates the pot. So it is called the clay is called the material cause. In Sanskrit, we call this as the Nimitta Karana and the Upadana Karana. The instrumental cause is called the Nimitta Karanam and the material cause is called the Upadana Karanam. The Vedas explain, the Upanishads explain that the creation of the whole universe, whole cosmos. Yekoham Bahusyam. I who am one, let me become many. Paramashiva's the consciousness, the Paramashiva's decision, will to become many and become the whole cosmos, all the worlds, is what is explained by the one word called Sarvaloka Yeka Janakam. The word Yeka means one, the only creator. He became everything. He became even the material cause of the whole world, and hence any formation, deformation within the material world that we see is still, for that even still, he is the sole creator, sole cause. Janaka means creator, the father. Sarvaloka Yeka Janakam. Natva Devam Maheshwaram. Natva, having bowed down to Devam Maheshwaram. That Deva, who is Maheshwara. Ishwara means the one who has the control over anything and everything. Maheshwara means the one who has the absolute control over everything. Because we call various deities, various, for example, even one of the grahas, the Shanishchara graha, we call as Shanishwara. Even Ravana was called Lankeshwara. He got the title of Ishwara. But who is the one who is the Lord, who is the Ishwara for anything and everything? Mahat. Mahat means is the whole cosmos. Who is the Lord of the whole cosmos? He is Paramashiva himself. Having bowed down to such Paramashiva, next, Samastaloka Janani Parvati Prahadurjatim. Samastaloka Janani, the mother of all the worlds, the creator, the mother, creator of all the worlds, that Parvati Devi, Praha, started telling, told, Dhurjatim. Dhurjati refers to the one who has a beautiful jata, beautiful jata, tied jatas is called dhur jati. Shiva Paramashiva has a beautiful jata in the in his head, so he is called dhur jati. So Devi Parvati asks Paramashiva. Then Devi Parvati starts speaking. Bhagavan Deva Devesha. O Bhagavan Deva Devesha, the Lord of all the other gods, all the other devas. Vatsalya Karuna Nidhe. Vatsalya means affection. Karuna Nidhi means, Karuna means compassion. Nidhi means treasure. He is the treasure of affection and compassion, of love and compassion. Here, Devi Parvati uses the words to call Paramashiva. He invokes him through the words Bhagavan. What is the word Bhagavan? It needs to be understood why she uses the word Bhagavan, Deva Devesha, and comes back to saying Vatsalya Karuna Nidhe. Bhagavan, the word refers to the one who has the eight qualities. Six qualities. The six qualities are Aishwaryasya Samagrasya Viryasya Yashasashriyaha Jnanavairagya Yoschaiva Shannam Bhagaitirana. The Lakshana for the word Bhaga. Bhagavan means the one who has the qualities called, the set of six qualities called Bhaga. The one who has the set of six qualities is called Bhagavan. What are these six qualities? Aishwaryasya Samagrasya, number one. Viryasya, 2. Yashasaha, 3. 4. Shriyaha, 4. Jnana, 5. And 6 is Vairagya. Here, we say Aishwaryasya Samagrasya. Aishwaryasya Samagrasya means all put together. All the qualities of the Ishwara put together is the one quality of Bhagavan. One quality of somebody who's called Bhagavan. One quality of the set of six qualities, which is called Bhaga. What does the word Aishwarya mean? Aishwarya means Ishwarasya Bhavaha, the quality of Ishwara, the qualities of the Dharma, qualities of Ishwara, the Lord. This eight qualities are there. These eight qualities are Anima, Laghima, Prapti, Prakamya, Mahima, Ishitvam, Vashitvam, Kama, Avashayita. All these eight are the eight qualities which are put together are called the Aishwarya. All these eight qualities are there in Paramashiva. Virya, courage. Virya also refers to the ability to create anything. Swamiji in one of his satsangs in the Upanishads explained, Virya is the quality in you by which you are not swayed by any of the hormonal changes within you. Virya, Swamiji explained in the Amritatva, when he was explaining the word Amritatva in the Upanishads, he explained the word Virya. The quality of Virya has to be in him. Yashas means fame. Fame refers to always the positive fame, means it's not being famous because of something noble that you are doing or some noble quality that you have is called Yashas. Shriya, Shri. Shri refers to all the wealth and prosperity. Shri refers to all the prosperity, all the wealth, anything that we think valuable in the life is Shri. Even water is Shri. water, gold, money, wealth, health, abundance, all these are put together is called Shri. The quality of abundance, the expansive quality is called Shri. Jnana means the ultimate state of enlightenment has to be in him. And Vairagya, Vairagya means Viragata, Raga means desire. Vairagya means the one who does not have any desire. Only an enlightened being cannot have any desire, because for him there is nothing more to do. For him nothing more is there to achieve, and hence he does not have any desire. So all these six qualities, Aishwarya, Virya, Yashas, Shri, Jnana and Vairagya are there in him. Aishwarya are the qualities of Paramashiva, are the qualities of the consciousness, direct powers of the consciousness. All of them are there in Paramashiva. She invokes Devi Parashakti, the cosmic mother. Parvati invokes Paramashiva with the word, with the quality of Bhagavan. Oh Lord, you have everything. You are the repository of all the powers of consciousness, all the best qualities in this whole cosmos. Who is the Lord of all the Devas, Deva Devas, all the Devas, the Lord of all the Devas. She invokes Paramashiva with these two qualities. He says, then she invokes him, his abundant compassion and love. You may be, O Bhagavan, O Lord Paramashiva, you may be the whole Lord of all the Devas. You are the supreme being in the whole cosmos. But kindly do have compassion towards us. She invokes the compassion component of Paramashiva, compassion aspect of Paramashiva, by calling him Vatsalya Karunanidhe, the embodiment, the treasure of love and affection. Shrutam Trailokya Vrittantam Twanmukham Bhojatav Pura. We have heard, she says, we have already heard all that is happening in the three lokas. Trailokya Vrittanta. Vrittanta means whatever happened in the three lokas. Vrittanta means whatever happened. Trailokya means all the three lokas. We already heard all whatever happened in the three lokas from your mouth. She uses the word Twanmukham Bhojatav Pura. Earlier, Mukamboja, from your lotus mouth, the mouth which is, she equates the mouth of Paramashiva to a lotus. In Tamil we call it as Thiruvayimmalarndarulinir. Munnar. Idanim. She says, she reminds him, you already, because of your out of deep compassion, you already revealed all these to us. Idanim Shrotumichami. Now I wish to hear Mahatmyam Atipavanam Samrajya Lakshmya Sarvajna Tanme Vistarato Vada. Now I wish to hear the great Mahatmya, great glory of Samrajya Lakshmi, which removes all the sins, all the karmas. Oh Sarvajna, she invokes him, saying Sarvajna, who knows, all knowing. Devi Parvati invokes the omniscience of Paramashiva here by calling him Sarvajna. You know everything, and hence kindly, out of your deep compassion and love for us, please open your mouth and reveal to us the greatness of Samrajya Lakshmi and elaborate on it. Vistarato vada, explain in elaboration, explain that to us. Vistarato vada. What is that glory? Why should we all hear that glory of Samrajya Lakshmi? Because it is Atipavanam. It removes all the sins, all the papas, all the bad karmas by listening. Then Shri Paramashiva replies, Shri Shivaha says, starts saying, Sadhu Sadhu Vararohe Yanmam Tvam. We'll first repeat the few verses and then continue to explain. Sadhu Sadhu Vararohe Yanmam Tvam Paripritchasi. तत्तेहं संप्रवक्ष्यामि सावधानमनाश्रुणु सन्मार्गवर्तिनां राज्ञां सन्मार्गवर्तिनां राज्ञां वर्तिनाम राज्ञाम साम्राज्य प्रतिपादनात् साम्राज्य लक्ष्मीरिति सा कथ्यते श्रीः जगत्त्रये परमशिवा स्टार्ट्स रिप्लाइंग साधु साधु शी ही स्टार्ट्स सेइंग नाउ वी से समथिंग समबडी आस्क्स अ क्वेश्चन वी स्टार्ट सेइंग वेल वी स्टार्ट सेइंग लाइक दैट परमशिवा स्टार्ट्स सेइंग वेल गुड नाइस ओके ही स्टार्ट्स सेइंग साधु साधु वारारोह ही कॉल्स देवी पराशक्ति देवी पार्वती विद द नेम वारारोह एंड वन थिंग नीड्स टू बी नोटेड हियर इज बिकॉज द रेफरेंस ऑफ पार्वती इज मेंशन्ड हियर द रिवेलेशन ऑफ दिस स्क्रिप्चर हैपेंड शुड हैव हैपेंड ड्यूरिंग द आफ्टर देवी पराशक्ति अज्यूम्ड द फॉर्म ऑफ पार्वती आफ्टर सतीस incarnation got over and after Devi assumed the form of Parvati, Parvataraja's putri should have happened. So from here, from this word Parvati, we understand the chronology of the event, of the happening, great happening of the revelation of this Agama. Vararoha means the one who is able to ride an elephant. Because Devi Parvati here asks for the greatness and glory of not some just how the inner science, inner world works. She asks about something, how the greatness of the Samrajya Lakshmi. Samrajya means Samrat means king. Samrat means king. Samrajya means the area. The zone, the domain of control of a king, Samrajya. When we say Samrajya, he has somebody, he's a great Samrat or he's the king of this Samrajya. It means that the king has complete sovereignty, control over that domain. It can be it need not be just only a physical place or physical area. It can also be some other zone, some other planes of the whole cosmos, whole universe. So Samrajya Lakshmi, which also includes about controlling many other things. It can also include about the ruling of a country. So she asks about a kingdom. So they Paramashiva also invokes that quality of the queen in Devi Parvati and calls her Vararohe, Vararoha. Oh, you are the one who's well trained, very very skilled in riding elephants. Yanmam tvam paripritchasi. Yat mam tvam paripritchasi. The word paripritchasi means again and again asking. Repeatedly asking, roundabout, keeping on asking. We understand from this that Devi Parashakti has been asking about this for quite a number of times and had been having a deep want to listen to the sacred truths behind the Samrajya Lakshmi. Tatteham sampravakshyami, that I will tell you now. I will tell. Savadhana manashrunu. Avadhana means awareness. Avadhana means concentration, awareness. Savadhana means avadhanena saha, along with awareness. How your mind should be when I start telling, revealing the sacred truths, Paramashiva reveals, saying that your mind should be full of awareness. It should be completely aware. So first come to awareness. First instruction given by Paramashiva to Devi Parvati, whoever is listening, and all the other rishis, munis, all the Ganeshwaras, Dikpalakas, all the Ashtaishwaryas, who are all the divine beings who are around him, he gives an instruction. Start listening with deep awareness is the first thing. Tatteham sampravakshyami savadhana manashrunu. With your mind engrossed in deep, complete awareness, please listen. First instruction that Paramashiva gives is become completely aware and start listening. So the teaching of Paramashiva starts with his instruction to become awareful and start listening. The first instruction is to listen. From the listening, the whole of the revelation that Paramashiva reveals here can be imbibed in each and every one of us. Sanmargavartinam rajnyam samrajya pratipadanat samrajya lakshmi ritisa kathyate shrihi jagatraye. Sanmargavartinam. Sanmarga, marga means way, path. Sanmarga means the right path, the correct path. Sanmarga means in the marga which is laid down by the dharma, dharma shastras, which is in accordance with the dharma, the path of life which is in accordance with dharma. Sanmarga vartinam, the one who is for all, the one who is established in the sanmarga, who is established in the path of dharma. Rajnyam, for all the kings. Samrajya pratipadanat, by pratipadana means by making it happen, by causing the samrajya to happen, by the causing of the samrajya to happen, by those kings who are established in the path of dharma, the shri, the wealth, the prosperity, the abundance, the expansion that is generated is called samrajya lakshmi. Because, understand, he explains the word samrajya lakshmi. Why the word samrajya, instead of just using the word samrajya, why it is called samrajya lakshmi, or just instead of being called as lakshmi, why it is called samrajya lakshmi is explained here by Paramashiva. The shri, the wealth, the fame, see, understand, shri does not only refer to richness, does not only refers to money. It refers to abundance, happiness, prosperity, unity in the family, unity in the country, unity in the nation, everything. All the qualities of prosperity put together are called Shri. That Shri of a king who is well established in the dharma, well established in the path of dharma, by causing the samrajya to happen. See, it's not just a nation, building of a nation. After a nation is built also, the nation should be sustaining. That is also causing of a nation, causing of a country, causing of a samrajya. So I create a huge property, but what if I don't protect the property from encroachment? Then it is all lost. So every action of mine to protect the property that I have created is also equivalent to causing of the property. Protection of an asset is equivalent to creation of that asset. So all that Shri is created by what? By causing a kingdom to happen. And hence it is called Samrajya Lakshmi. Lakshmi means Shri. Shri also means Lakshmi. And because this Shri is related to Samrajya and happens because of the happening, causing of the happening of Samrajya, it is called Samrajya Lakshmi. That Shri, that Devi is called Samrajya Lakshmi. Now he starts not only using the word Samrajya Lakshmi just to mention about wealth and abundance, but specifically to a Devi, specifically to Devi Lakshmi herself. How we know about this? From the next verses, Paramashiva starts explaining. Yasyah katakshapatranam nrupanam nayachakshusham dhanadhanya samruddhani rashtrani nagarani cha ayatnenaiva siddhyanti natrakarya vicharana. We'll all read it once. Yasyah katakshapatranam. Nripanam nayachakshusham. Dhanadhanya samruddhani. Rashtrani nagarani cha. Ayatne naiva siddhyanti. Natra karya vicharana. Yasyah kataksha patranam. Nrupanam nayachakshusham. Dhanadhanya samruddhani. Rashtrani nagarani cha. Ayatne naiva siddhyanti. Natra karya vicharana. So he says, yasyaha katakshapatranam rupanam nayachakshusham. Kataksha means, in Tamil we call it as kadaikan parvai. See, aksha means eyes. Kata means corner. Kataksha means the corner sight. Just seeing, not even just seeing directly, seeing with the corner sight. Why do we emphasize in the Hindu Sanatana Dharma, so much emphasis is given on receiving the kataksha of any deity, whether it is Paramashiva, Parashakti, or the kataksha of Guru himself. What is the significance of kataksha? All the balasans, are you listening? Suppose there is a mother who is given birth to a child, and the child is a crawling child who's playing in the corner, and she has to do some other work. She is doing so many other works, whether she is cooking, whether she is speaking to somebody else. While doing something else, if she is stitching some clothes, then her whole mind will be, whole inner space will be engrossed in that work. Whatever it is, her one corner of her eyes will always be looking at her child, looking at her baby. The care is what is the care and the grace. Just by the corner, little eyesight, she has the control. She monitors. She monitors what the baby does. She monitors. She cares. And she allows the baby to play whatever way it wants. But the moment she sees, if suppose the baby tries to put her hand inside a electric socket, the moment she sees, she runs and grabs the child. Takes the child in her control. She protects. The protection, the grace is extremely important. The word kataksha is extensively used in invoking the grace of the Guru, grace of Mahalakshmi, grace of all the devatas in the Hindu Sanatana Dharma. Kataksha means the corner eyesight. Why do we say corner eyesight? Instead, he can say continuously, look at me. He can be engaged in any other action. Paramashiva can be engaged, or they hear Mahalakshmi, Samaraji Lakshmi can be doing any other thing. But her eye corner eyesight, that grace, her motherly touch is always there. To the one who has that grace of the cosmic mother, that grace of the deity, with which he is protected, taken care of, and given all the best things and the ultimate enlightenment itself, that is called kataksha. Are we all understanding? In Tamil, we call this as kadaikkan parvai, the corner eyesight. Yasya kataksha patranam. Yasya kataksha patranam. For the kataksha to happen, he represents there is a patra. Patra means a vessel. The rain happens all over the planet Earth. All over the, if the rain happens in Bidhi, it happens everywhere. If it happens in Bangalore, it happens everywhere. But does all place, each and every place, hold the rain water? No. Only if the place is has a some trough kind of a, which is kind of a vessel, kind of a lowering, a pit kind of a place, only then it can hold the rainwater. Same way, the grace of divine happens in every being in the whole cosmos equally. In the Hindu Sanatana Dharma, we say one important quality of Paramashiva, one important quality of the divine is not being biased towards anybody, any one being. His grace happens like sunshine. His grace happens like rain everywhere. When Swamiji blesses, he blesses the whole cosmos. Whether we become receptive for that grace to retain in us is all the question. Here, the word yasya kataksha patranam, to all those who have become receptive and who have become a patra, who have become eligible to hold the kataksha, the grace of that devata, Samrajya Lakshmi. Are we all understanding? Here, the Paramashiva is explaining here, dhanadhanya samriddhani, so many things, dhana, wealth, dhanya, grains, samriddhani, prosperity, rashtrani, country, nagarani, cities, all those happen without any effort. All these happen without any effort to whom? To the one who has become receptive and who has made himself eligible to hold the grace of that Devi Samrajya Lakshmi. So he emphasizes on, Paramashiva here emphasizes on the patratva, the ability to hold. The ability is not an extraordinary ability. Making ourselves, how do we make ourselves eligible for that divine grace of Samrajya Lakshmi to happen in each and every one of us, and that grace to be held within us? Paramashiva already gave a sentence, gave a word saying, Sanmargavartinam Rajyam. If you live a life adhering to Dharma, if your life is in accordance with the cosmic law, if your life is in accordance with the Vedas, Agamas, Dharma Shastras, Griha Sutras, all the great scriptures, all the cosmic truths, cosmic law, then you live a life of Sanmarga. If you live a life of Sanmarga, then you become eligible to hold the grace of Samrajya Lakshmi, Devi Mahalakshmi herself. For such a being, such beings who have become eligible to, who have made themselves eligible to receive and hold the grace of Samrajya Lakshmi, and for such kings who live a righteous, dharmic life, Nayachakshusha means the eye of prudence, means being so meticulous in doing things, infusing intense meticulousness in every inch of our life. Swamiji tells micromanaging. When we start micromanaging, that quality, if anybody has that quality of micromanagement, he also becomes eligible for the grace of Samrajya Lakshmi to happen in his life. For him, for that, such a king, for such divine, for such beings, what happens? Dhana, wealth, dhanya, grains, samruddhani, all the prosperity, and rashtrani, nation, country, nagarani means all these cities and towns, all these happen. Siddhanti means it just like that happens. How does it happen with, okay, all these beings, such a king who is well established in the path of Dharma, what should he do to make his kingdom happen, makes great cities, make wealth and prosperity happen? Nothing. He says, ayatnena. Yatna means effort. We need to understand the yatna does not refer to effort, does not refer to a physical action of doing something. Yatna means effort happens in one's inner space. The shastras explain that, why I am telling this, explaining the word ayatne naiva, is when you become receptive, when you receive the grace of Samrajya Lakshmi, the greatness of grace of Samrajya Lakshmi, what does it do? Even within you creating a will to make this happen, it just like that happens. All these great prosperities happen. The four steps before any action happens is, if I need to pick this tab in my hand, then I need to know that I can pick it up, that there is a tab and I need to pick it up. That is called Janati. Ichchati, then next one is I need to have a wish to pick it up. Yatna is prayatna, is third thing which happens within one's antahkarana, the inner space, to pick it up. Next only the physical picking up happens. So here Paramashiva explains, ayatnenaiva siddhyanti. He does not even just making some action outside, even the action of the antahkarana, action within your inner space to make something, to create something to happen, without even doing that action within the inner space, all these great auspiciousness happen to the one who has already received the grace of Samrajya Lakshmi. Remember, Devi Parvati asked the greatness of Samrajya Lakshmi, Mahatmya Mati Pavanam. So he starts explaining the, first starts explaining the greatness of that Samrajya Lakshmi. Next he says, Patranam Yatkatakshanam Nripanam Dharmashilinam Ashtaishwaryani Nrityanti Murtimanti Grihe Grihe. We'll repeat. Patranam Yatkatakshanam Nripanam Dharmashilinam Ashtaishwaryani Nrityanti Murtimanti Grihe Grihe. Yatkatakshanam Patranam Nripanam Dharmashilinam Grihe Grihe Murtimanti Ashtaishwaryani Nrityanti. In such beings who have become eligible, made themselves eligible for the grace of Samrajya Lakshmi, in those beings, in those kings whose character, whose livelihood, whose life itself has become dharma, dharmashilinam, dharma shilam yasya saha dharmashili, the one who has made his character completely righteous, dharmic, is called dharmashili. For such kings and for such beings, in their houses, for each and every being who have made themselves eligible like this, in their house, in every house, grihe grihe, he may have so many houses. In every house there, murtimanti, murtiman means, murti means form. Form, the one who has form is murtiman. The one who has form is human beings. In such human beings, ashtaishwaryani nrityanti. Ashtaishwarya, we already saw. What are the ashtaishwaryas? Anima, laghima, all the eight Ashtaishwaryas which we already now saw while we are explaining the word Bhaga, Aishwaryasya Samagrasya, when we were explaining, I explained the word, gave what list of the Aishwarya, the qualities of Ishwara. All those Ashtaishwarya, all the powers, what are the powers of Ishwara? These powers of Ishwara dance in those houses. It doesn't say that, Paramashiva does not say that it happens in their houses. They just like that dance. The powers of Paramashiva. So, not only by the grace of the Samrajya Lakshmi, one attains wealth, outer world wealth, but also enjoys all the powers of Paramashiva without any effort. The next is Yasya Kataksha Lakshyanam. This word, here there is a, in the scripture, there is a printing error that has happened. Yasya Kataksha Lakshyanam Grihadvareshu Bhubhujam Sampadyate. The next word is vague because some ink has got blotted in that place. Jambu Nadiva Chitritam. So, yasya kataksha lakshyanam, kataksha lakshya, the one who has become the goal of the kataksha of Samrajya Lakshmi. Are we understanding? If somebody has become receptive, somebody has become eligible for the grace of this Devi, Samrajya Lakshmi, then the grace of Kataksha of Samrajya Lakshmi falls on them. So he is called the goal of the Kataksha. He becomes the goal of the Kataksha of that Samrajya Lakshmi. Yasya Kataksha Lakshyanam. The Kataksha's Lakshya they have become the lakshya of the kataksha of Devi Samraj Lakshmi herself. For them, bhu bhuja means bhumi, bhuja means arms. The one who has the bhumi itself as his bhuja. We always say, when you say power, we always show like this. We call it in Sanskrit called bhujaparakramam. Your ability, your strength, you show. Strength is always referred in our life with the biceps. So, here, Paramashiva explains, the one to whom bhumi, land has, the nation has become a shakti, a strength. Who's such a person? For a king, only for a kshatriya, only for a king, the bhumi becomes a strength for him. The bhumi itself becomes a power for him. How much ever land is within his control, that becomes his strength and power. For such kings, yasya kataksha lakshyanam grihadvareshu bhubujam. In the grihadvara, earlier he told, for them, for such great kings who are righteous, all the dhana and dhanya, everything just like that happens. And next he said, in their houses, Ashtaishwarya dance. And then now he says, at their doorstep, not just in their home, at their doorstep, gold happens. Jambunada means gold. Jambunadiva chitritam. Their doorsteps are filled with gold. So much of, understand, gold does not only refer to some equivalent of money. We have so many things which are more costly and expensive than gold. Diamonds have been expensive than gold since time immemorial. But nowhere we give a mention of diamonds. We always give a mention of gold. Why? Gold represents tejas. Are we listening? Gold represents tejas. Gold represents directly the fire element itself. Agni, tejas. Gold. Tejas is the quality of Paramashiva. Paramashiva is embodiment of fire. He is tejas swarupa. So, this gold is direct mention, direct representation of physical representation of Paramashiva's radiance. The Vedas explain saying, Om Namo Bhagavate Hiranyavarnaya Hiranyarupaya Hiranyapataye. Paramashiva is explained as Hiranyarupa. His form is golden. Hiranyapati, he is the lord of the golden splendor. So, why we always emphasis on gold, whether it is the golden temple or the Swarna Tulabhara or anything that is gold, why we always use gold and emphasis on gold? Here also Paramashiva explains, gold is there outside their home, filled with, means the whole house is already filled and there is no space, furthermore it's overflowing of the divine grace of Paramashiva in the form of wealth, and the divine radiance happens in their houses. Next he explains, yasya katakshamatrena. So the next Paramashiva starts explaining, continues to explain the greatness of the just kataksha. Also why he says kataksha. If her just grace, corner eye vision, grace of that Samrajya Lakshmi itself can cause this much of abundance and prosperity and divinity in a place, what to say about her direct vision, her direct grace, complete grace to happen? Here Paramashiva, every time continuing going forward also, many shlokas Paramashiva explains about the Kataksha of Mahalakshmi. One, Kataksha is extraordinarily important because even if the Devata is doing something else, is engaged in some other work, her constant vision, constant, she's, you are hooked onto her vision, hooked onto her sight. That is explained. And another thing is the greatness of the Devata. That greatness of the Devata is known by saying the Kataksha itself can do much this much. Then you imagine what her grace, by her vision, by her initiation, by her appearance, by her darshan, so many things can happen. So Paramashiva explains all these. Again, we'll read once what we learned today. Please repeat it once, because we already repeated twice. Sarva lakshana sampannam sachidananda rupinam sarva lokaika janakam natva devam maheshwaram samasta loka janani Parvati praha dhurjatim Bhagavan deva devesha Vatsalya karunanidhe Shrutam trailokya vrittantam Tvan mukham bhoja tafpura Idanim shrotumichhami Mahatmyamati pavanam Samrajya lakshmya sarvajnya Tanme vistaratovada Sadhu sadhu vararohe Yanmam tvam paripritchasi Tatteham sampravakshyami Savadhanam anashrunu Sanmargavartinam rajnyam Samrajya pratipadanat Samrajya Lakshmiritisa Kathyate Shrir Jagatraye Yasyah Katakshapatranam Nrupanam Naya Chakshusham Dhanadhanya Samriddhani Rashtrani Nagarani Cha Ayatne naiva siddhyanti Natra karya vicharana Patranam yatkatakshanam Drupanam dharmashilinam Ashtaishwaryani nrityanti Murtivanti Gruhe Gruhe Yasyah Kataksha Lakshyanam Gruhadvare Shubhubhujam Sampadyate Jambu Nadi Vachitritam. Here, one thing important, Paramashiva in the 13th shloka also says, Natra Karya Vicharana. There is nothing to be investigated in it. Because Paramashiva says, Ayatne Naiva Siddhanti, without they doing anything, even within their inner space, all these sampat, all these great prosperities happen in their life. And he says, Natra Karya Vicharana. There is nothing to be investigated in this. No need of investigation in it, because he says it is Satya. So, Yasyah katakshamatrena Matangamada vihkvalaha. We'll continue with the rest of the verses starting from the verse that we read last from in tomorrow's session. It is always a tradition when you, we will not stop with anything. You will start the next verse and leave it. If you read Bhagavad Gita completely, the 18 chapters, after that you read the first chapters, first verse, at least starting line once and leave it. If you are reading the 10th chapter of Bhagavad Gita, then you start the 11th chapter of Bhagavad Gita's first line and stop it. So we stop today's class with the next verse, which you'll be seeing in the next session. Thank you, Nityananda. We'll close this with the Purna Mantra. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi Harihi Om Tat Sat Sarvam Sadguru Padukarpanamastu Om Nityanandam.